class 3. Today we are going to do a new chapter, that is chapter 5, and the name of the chapter is birds. In this chapter we are going to study about the features of the birds, like the feather of the birds, the beak of the birds, the leg and the the feet and the claws of the birds. So what are the common birds we see in our places? Usually we see sparrows, right? We see pigeons, we can see parrots sometimes, we see duck, hen, cock. This all we see in our places. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the feather. So what is a feather? Because birds is the only animal which have a feather. Unlike we, or the animals, we usually have a hair or we have a fur. And if you see the fish, they have a scales. But it's only the bird which has a feather. And you can see the feather are of different color, different shapes, and they are so beautiful. Some of like, even if you see the crow, though it's black in color, it has its own beauty, right? So we are going to study about the feather. Look at the peacock, it's so beautiful, so colorful, right? So I think the bird is, it looks very beautiful. And the feather are of two types. It's a down feather, D-O-W-N, down feathers, and the flight feathers. Down feathers are the feathers which covers the body of the birds. It's small in shape, and what happens, it covers all the throughout the body of the birds, and that helps the body to keep themselves warm. And they have another feather, that's going to be the flight feather. Flight feathers usually present in the wings and in the tail, and it is quite longer that compared to the down feathers. Okay, and these feathers help the bird to fly, and also the tail helps the bird to change the direction. Exactly in a fish, what happens? The fins helps the fish to swim, and the tail of the fish helps the fish to change the direction. And the next topic is going to be, okay, the second topic is how birds fly. Not all the birds can fly. There are some flightless birds like the penguin, like the ostrich. Why they cannot fly? It's because they have a very heavy body as compared to their wings. The wings are smaller, and what happened? The body is heavy. That's the reason they won't be able to fly. But most of the birds, they can fly. And how they can fly? First of all, they have a very strong and light bones. And if you see the bones of the bird, what happens? Suppose this is a bone, this is a inside, it's what happened, it is hollow. Hollow means the inside of the bone is hollow, means it is empty. That's the reason what happens, the bone of the birds are light. Light means it's not heavy. And also what happens, the shape of the bird is a boat shape. That also helps the bird to fly. And also the chest, it have got a very strong chest, because that helps the bird to move for the movement of their wings, and they have to use a lot of force. That's the reason what happened, they have a very strong chest which helps the bird to move their wings and help them fly. Hello class 3, this is a second part from the chapter birds. And in the first video, I think we have discussed about the feather of the birds and the how do birds fly. In this chapter, we are going to study about the different kind of beaks of the birds, and also about the feet and claws. So first, let's discuss about the beak of the beak of the birds. Now look at this. This is a beak of the birds. Unlike us, we have a teeth. They don't have a teeth. So they use this for eating food. Okay, and it's not only eating food. These have a many uses. The beak have a very many uses. For example, for building nest. Okay, they build a nest with the help of the beak. Like they collect twigs, right? Like branches, feathers, etc. to make the beak with the help of, to make a nest with the help of the beak. And also, they feed the young ones with their beak, right? And and they use this beak for the defense system. Defense system is like when a predator, like a bigger birds, they try to attack them. What happened? They use this beak to fight back with the enemies. So it have a many uses. So now, like, different birds have different kind of beak. Some are big, some are small, some are very, like, you know, very huge, right? So it depends upon the type of food they eat. Okay, now let's study the different kinds of beak. And just to inform you, this is not in your book. I've just referring this so that you can understand it better. So first we are going to read about the eagle. So if you see the eagle closely, now what kind of beak does the eagle have? It is strong and it is hooked. In the end, hook means it kind of bent, like it is slightly curved in the end. How does this beak help the bird for catching what? It's for catching prey and also for tearing the flesh. Usually the what eagle eat, they eat a flesh, that they eat a meat. So it helps the eagle to tear the flesh. And the second one, this is a parrot. If you have seen the parrot, it have a curved. Curved means it is little curved like this, okay, beak. And like kind of semicircle, okay, the curve is kind of semicircle. Then what happened? How does this beak help the parrot to eat? It helps the parrot to break the nuts. Okay, usually they can break the nut with the help of their beak. And the third one is a duck. If you see a duck properly, it has a broad and flat. And you can see two holes here. Have you seen how the duck eat their food? Usually in a, like in a muddy and a dirty water place, usually they'll be trying to find the food. So what happens? Whatever food they get, they swallow inside, and the dirt and the water they throw from these two holes. And the fourth one is going to be sparrow. Sparrow have a, it is short but strong. Okay, it is short but strong. This helps the sparrow for crushing. Because usually what they eat grain, rice, right? It helps them to crush the grains. And we have the hummingbird. Look at the, it is long and cylinder. Usually what does the hummingbird, I think it's the smallest bird. And what does it do? It usually drinks the nectar from the flower. Nectar is like in the like in the end of the flower, in the base of the flower, what happens? There is some sweet thing, sweet liquid. That is what the hummingbird like to eat. So what that's the reason they have a very long and cylinder so that it can reach the base of the flower. Okay, now we will discuss the types of feet. Okay, feet. Usually the birds have 2 feet. And it have 4 toes and toes, this is the toes, these are toes, and this is the nail is called the claws. These 4 is the toes and usually they have 4 toes and they have claws. Okay, so hoodpecker have like 2 in the front and 2 in the back. That helps them to climb the tree. This kind of feet helps them to climb the tree. This is 2 toes and they have 2 more toes at the back. Here it's hidden, one is hidden here. It has been somewhere here. It has a 2 at the front, 2 at the back. And this is a duck. You see duck, it have a 3 toes. But you see here, this is like a skin attaching the toes. Okay. And this helps the duck to swim in the water. And a vulture, it has a very strong claws. Okay. It have a very strong, this helps them to grab the prey or a food from the ground, and it helps them to carry. Okay, and also like it helps them to hold the prey and eat. Now sparrow, now look at the sparrow. Okay, the sparrow have 3 toes, that is 3 toes here, 1, 2, 3 at the front and 1 at the back. This helps them to sit on the branches of the tree or a or electrical lines. Okay, the last one is crane. Look at the feet of the crane. Look it properly. Okay, they have a very long, they have a long feet, and look at, they have a very, they have a 3 toes and they are very far apart from each other. This helps them to walk near the water, a bank of the rivers and lakes to eat fish. Okay, this helps them to walk near the bank of the rivers and lakes to eat fish. Okay, this much we have for in this chapter, and take care. Bye-bye.